Okay, so today we are gonna do Common People by Pulp. So another Britpop band here. I did do another, I guess, Britpop band yesterday in Suede. So yeah, I don't know, we're rolling with this week, I guess. But this was requested, and since I am a fan of, Oasis and Blur and the Verve, I never really went beyond those bands in Britpop. And I know the song, I've heard about the song, I know it's big, but I've never actually listened to it. So this will be a pure reaction. So let's get into it, and I'll see if I do recognize it or not. But anyway, let's go.
St. Martin's College, that's where I
very bouncy.
Caught her eye. She told me that the tap was loaded. I said, in that case, I'll have room with Coca-Cola. She said, fine. And then in 30 seconds time, she said, I wanna live like common people. I wanna do whatever common people do. Wanna sleep with common people. I wanna sleep with common people like you. What else could I do? I said, oh, I'll see what I can do. I took her to a supermarket. I don't know why, but I just started somewhere. So it started there. Pretend you got no money. And she just laughed and said, oh, you're so funny. I said, yeah, I can't see anyone else smiling. Are you sure? You wanna live like common people. You wanna see whatever common people see. Wanna sleep with common people. You wanna sleep with common people like me. But she didn't understand. And she just smiled and held my hand.
Yes.
Okay, so that was intriguing. I get a lot of things going through my mind right now, but first I want to just say, I really like the synthesizer in there. I could hear the organ. I just gotta say off the bat, because at the end there, near the end at least, those were coming through, and I really like that. So anyway, it says the vocalist here. Like I said, I'm saying a lot, but like I said, I have not heard the song or band. I did not recognize it when I was listening to it. But the vocalist is Jarvis Cocker. It's quite the name. Then on the synthesizer, Candida Doyle, and guitar Mark Weber, bass guitar Steve Mackey, violin. They had a violin here. Nick Banks, piano as well, and Dudley. And yeah, that's about it. And also an organ was Jarvis Cocker again, and guitar as well, it says, acoustic guitar. So anyway, yeah, so I mean this song, I really liked the talking parts. I hate how I'm saying so much, but I'm trying to think of everything in my head. But it reminded me of Blur's Park Life, and also Counting Crows Round Here, just because those songs also, they kind of talk in them. And I always like when when an artist talks. I'm just realizing now how many times they say in a video, but I like when artists talk in a song instead of, just singing all the way through. And it's just something different. And also here with Jarvis talking, he was basically talking, I guess, to the listeners. And without actually reading anything into it, I just want to see if I'm right here and say that the song, I guess, would be Jarvis talking about a girl. So it says right off the bat, she came from Greece. She had a thirst for knowledge. She studied scripture at St. Martin's College. That's where I caught her eye. She told me that her dad was loaded. So basically, yeah, he's got a lot of money. I said, in that case, I'll have a rum and Coca-Cola. She said, fine. And I guess the other way of, loaded, drunk. Okay, so that's pretty cool. She said, fine. And then in 30 seconds' time, she said, I want to live like common people. So basically, she's very wealthy. She comes from a very wealthy family. And this guy is, common people. I guess he's more working class, middle class kind of guy, maybe even lower class. And she's saying, I want to live like common people. I want to do whatever they do. And the guy's kind of like, maybe actually you don't. I don't think you actually understand. And I guess you could really see this throughout, I guess, the rest of the song with the second verse. I took her to the supermarket. I have to start somewhere. I said, pretend you got no money. Because, a lot of people, some people don't got money. They can't, buy things in a supermarket, unlike her. And she just laughed and said, oh, you're funny. I said, yeah. Well, I can't see anyone else smiling in here. Are you sure? So I also like right there. I think he laughed as well when he said that. I just liked his delivery, and it's almost he's almost whispering as well, and almost like a little bit of ASMR. You're getting a little bit of tingles. Anyway, and then we go on with the chorus once again, and then we have the bridge, and here the bridge as well. Oh, rent a flat above a shop and cut your hair and get a job and smoke some cigarettes. I don't really want to say the FAGS just because, anyway, and play some pool, but I know it also means cigarette. Pretend you never went to school, but still you'll never get it right because when you're laid in bed at night, watching the roaches climb the wall. I mean, oh my goodness. I mean, yeah, that really reminds me of actually a YouTuber I watch, the Angry Grandpa show. The Angry Grandpa passed away 3 years ago now, I think, but they said that they were trailer trash, and you could always see in a video, you could see some roaches crawling on the walls and all this kind of thing. So yeah, roaches, I mean, and also I think roaches are more attracted to mobile homes because of the wood that it's made with. But anyway, yeah, just talking about roaches, I think actually thinking about other YouTubers with like H3H3, I know they used to live in a bad apartment and they had roaches and such and mice. So yeah, it's just like you want to live like a common person or like a lower class person. I mean, this is what it is. And then also he says, if you called your dad, he could stop it all. And it's like, but common people don't have that option. Their dad or their mom is also probably struggling even maybe more worse than their offspring. So anyway, and then we have the third chorus here, and I like this. It's just he says, you'll never live like common people. You'll never do whatever common people do. So he's basically saying, he's cutting to the chase here. Actually, like, yeah, you're not gonna actually live like common people. I think you're out of it here. You'll never watch your life slide out of view and then dance and drink and screw because there's nothing else to do. I really like the rhyming as well here. And then the fourth chorus, a lot of choruses, sing along with the common people, sing along and it might just get you through. Laugh along with the common people, laugh along even though they're going to laugh at you and the stupid things that you do because you think that poor is cool. So right there, that's like a premonition for me, because you think being poor is cool. So I can really see why this song is so big. And I'm surprised I have not heard it, like I said. But anyway, we go on to the next verse here. Like a dog lying in a corner, they will bite you and never warn you. Look out, they'll tear your insides out because everybody hates a tourist. especially one who thinks it's all such a laugh. So he's really going in now. Yeah, and the chip stains and grease will come out in the bath. You will never understand how it feels to live your life with no meaning or control. And with nowhere left to go, you are amazed that they exist and they burn so bright whilst you can only wonder why. So again, yeah. And actually, you know, I'm on Twitter, you know, Twitter's, you know, a big app. And and there's a lot of, I don't know, I've been seeing a lot more recently about, you know, the minimum wage and, you know, how much a McDonald's worker should make. And then there's the, over in Denmark, I think it was, and how they pay their employees pretty well. And the price of a hamburger only went up by, I can't remember, like 45 cents or something like that. And, but everyone's more happy. And I do know that Denmark is one of the happiest places on earth or something like that. But, yeah, it's just really giving me those vibes right now where it's like this girl kind of sits high and mighty. I mean, you got, you know, like people who own McDonald's and such, who, you know, run it and they make millions every year. And then you got the employees who, you know, are trying to raise minimum wage and such. And, yeah, so it's just, you're amazed that they exist. It's just, yeah, giving me those vibes and reminding me of Twitter, I guess, basically, that I've seen recently, the tweets I've seen. So, yeah, and then again, we had the bridge again about rent a flat above a shop, cut your hair and get a job. I mean, yeah, again, it's like he's telling her, you're not ready for this. You think you know what's going on, but you think it's all a laugh, really. And, yeah. So anyway, that's what I guess that was my interpretation, I guess, but, I went on there, but, yeah. So I just wanted to look on Wikipedia here, just, you know, talk a little bit more about the song before I wrap it up here, because basically it is what I said it was, I guess. But anyway, so it says the inspiration for the song was, the lyrics came from a Greek art student whom Pulp singer-songwriter Jarvis Cocker, still love that name, met while he was studying at the Central St. Martin's College of Art and Design. So like he said in the song, Cocker had enrolled in a film studies course at the college in September 1988. While taking a break from Pulp, he spoke about the song's inspiration. Okay, so here it is now. I had met the girl from the song many years before when I was at St. Martin's College. I had met her on a sculpture course, but at St. Martin's, you had a thing called Crossover Fortnight, where you had to do another discipline for a couple weeks. I was studying film, and she might have been doing painting, but we both decided to do sculpture for 2 weeks. I don't know her name. It would have been around 1988, so it was already ancient history when I wrote about her. And then we go on, this is a long quote. In a 2012 question and answer on BBC, Cocker said that he was living or having a conversation with the girl at a bar at the college because he was attracted to her, although he found some aspects of her personality unpleasant. He remembered that at one point she told him she wanted to move to Hackney and live like the common people. So she really was the inspiration here. Cocker used this phrase as the starting point for the song and embellished the situation for dramatic effect. For example, reversing the situation in the song with the female character declares that, I want to sleep with common people like you. Cocker said in real life he had been wanting to sleep with the girl while she had not been interested in him. Well, that's pretty sad. Taking this inspiration, the narrator explains that his female acquaintance can never be like common people because even she gets a flat where roaches climb the wall. Ultimately, if she called her dad, he could stop it all. In contrast to the true common people who can only watch their lives slide out of view. So yeah, again, he really took this inspiration and made it As you can see here, it says in a 2015 Rolling Stone readers poll, it was voted as the greatest Britpop song. And I mean, you get a lot of songs in there, but I can really see why this would be voted as that. And I have heard so much praise for the song, but again, it just, I don't know, went by me. But anyway, it was their lead single off their fifth studio album. My goodness, different class. And also, I mean, that title grabs you as well. Different class, common people. We're seeing a theme here. And it became the defining track of the Britpop movement and Pulp's signature song in the process. So, also, it says BBC Radio 6 music listeners voted it as their favorite Britpop song in an online poll. So, obviously, this song has been very highly touted. And this video is over 17 minutes long. So anyway, I'm going to wrap it up. But I will say that, yeah, the song, I really love the story here. And it does really give me kind of, you know, Verve vibes just because of, and I guess Oasis vibes and Blur vibes. I mean, these bands were not rich. I mean, a lot of bands aren't rich, but I mean, they didn't have a lot of money. And they talked about that. I know Noel Gallagher wrote about that, talking about, you know, being a rock and roll star, even though he was poor and they didn't really have success then. And then we have like the Verve with Bittersweet Symphony. You know, it's a Bittersweet Symphony. I can't remember not the title, the lyric, try to make ends meet. You're a slave to the money, then you die. I mean, kind of the same themes here. And yeah, it's just what a great genre with some great songs and bands. So anyway, I guess that's about it. Thanks for the request. I finally got it done. And yeah, thank you for the support. Love everything. Love the subscriptions. Thanks. I guess I could say thank you for subscribing, commenting, liking. That's what I usually say. And yeah, I just really appreciate the support. And anyway, I guess I'll talk to you guys again soon. Thank you very much.